Welcome to Book Time with Ryan. I am Ryan, and today I'll be talking about The Powers, The Secret History of Deena Pilgrim. This is by Brian Michael Bendis and Neil Kleid. There's a little shot of the cover. Look, there's superheroes over here. This is, I'm going to try to describe what it is. I think I have an idea of what it is. It says it's by Brian Michael Bendis and Neil Kleid, but I think it's really by Neil Kleid, and I don't know if Brian Michael Bendis gave his permission or reviewed it or just made sure that it fell into continuity with the other Powers books. I got this book 3 years ago, and before I got it, I had finished the Powers series, which is a comic book, is it a comic book or graphic novel? The stuff that's referred to in this book took place in all of these. This is number 7. There's obviously 6 other ones. And then there are some later, which I think probably came after The Secret History of Deena Pilgrim. I love Powers. I love it. And you should too. It's by Brian Michael Bendis and Michael Avon Oeming. Oeming is the illustrator, and Brian Michael Bendis is the writer. But this feels like a fan fiction. Now, I got this almost 3 years ago in May 2021. I ordered it online, and what I initially got from Amazon was not The Secret History of Deena Pilgrim, but The Secrets of Midwives, or The Secret Lives of Midwives, which I returned because I did not want to know about midwife secrets. Not at all. But I did want to know about history and the secret history of Deena Pilgrim. Obviously, this is fiction. So I think this is a fan fiction because while Brian Michael Bendis' name is on this, I'm pretty sure Neil did the writing. The interesting thing is the back talks about Brian Michael Bendis the entire time, which I don't get, but I like this. So Powers is a series about two cops, Christian Walker and Deena Pilgrim, and they work in a Powers homicide bureau. Powers are people with powers, superpowers, and there is a special unit that handles cases involving powers. By the time we get to this book, a lot has happened in 7 very thick comic book series, graphic novel series, issues before. I mean, 7 big books. Obviously, there are a bunch of comics. I didn't read them way back, so I read them as these condensed forms. We kind of have an idea of what the main character, I guess they're both main characters. They're both very likable. Deena Pilgrim is scrappy. I don't know if she's sexy, but you would have fun with her. She's cool. And I think people would be attracted to her. I don't know. But she's tough. She grew up in a kind of rough household. Not horrible in a traditional sense, but really, you don't know what the background is when you're reading the Powers books. And that's what this Secrets book really kind of clears up. It kind of alternates between just around Christmas, present day, whenever that is, and 12 years in the past. And we go to Deena's kind of birthplace, or the area she grew up in, Atlanta. And there's these references to this kind of gang war, civil warfare that happened in Atlanta that involved anti-Powers people, which are bigots, and Powers and the police force. Different factions were fighting it out. This is before Deena Pilgrim was a cop. Her father was a cop. Her father's best friend was a judge. She had a guy she was interested in named Aaron Boucher, or Boucher, Booker, Booker. Boucher? Boucher? I don't know. There's a bunch of different ways to pronounce it. The book opens with a murder, and the murder is of somebody that had powers. And not only is it somebody with powers, but it was somebody who you would think of as like a Captain America. somebody who fought in wars, had powers, was really the poster child of patriotism, worked for the government, and then kept being a superhero after. But the guy has lost a lot of his power. He's really pretty down, and he dies in the first chapter, first scenes maybe. So Deena and her partner respond, and they quickly become aware that not only is this a power, but he also has a secret of his own, because he has a tattoo of this bigoted organization called the Human Front, which were anti-powers. From there, we find out that there's still some fallout from things that happened earlier, and Christian Walker, her partner, who used to be a power, named Diamond, and he's lived for centuries, so he had other aliases too. He is being interviewed by somebody from a commission just to see if members of law enforcement should be people with powers or former power holders. And honestly, it was long enough ago that I read the comics. I don't exactly remember why he would be interviewed at this point, because generally Deena and Christian are, they're good characters. They're good people. You would like them. And while they're both flawed in some way, their positive sides definitely outweigh the negative, the minor negative points in their characters. I don't remember what Christian Walker did in the past to warrant this investigation by commission, but we start to figure out that this death of a power at the beginning of the book is one in a chain of murders by some hooded vigilante. We're not sure who it is. And the book is basically Deena, especially because Christian's been called off the case because of his connection with the first murder suspect, Joe, who was called a citizen soldier. It's hard to say. Say it. Try it. Citizen soldier. They probably could have... I would have picked a different name if I was a superhero. And I might be. You never know. But I could be. But I wouldn't tell you. Walker can't be on the case because he's too close to the victim. So it's really Deena, and Deena picks up a new partner named... Kirk. I can't remember if Kirk is his first or last name, I think it's last name, but he's a rookie. He's new. She takes him under her wing, and she's a little abusive, but like in a good way. She's abusive in a good way. And he gets hurt. A lot of people get hurt. People die. And the book is really looking at the current murders and trying to piece together why this is happening. And there's some connection to Deena's past. So we alternate, maybe not every other chapter, but we're often alternating between present day, kind of like a time tick over a 3-day span, and going back to memories from 12, 11 and a half, 10 years ago. Because Aaron Booker, or Boucher, has popped back up, and he is the one interviewing Walker for the commission to review his record. And he's also the one that Deena was in love with in Atlanta 10 years before. So there are connections between the current murders and the past. That's the whole point of the book. And it will keep you guessing. I think to enjoy this book, you really need to know Powers. It's very fun if you understand the background of Powers and you are aware of what the different characters have been through, because it really is a continuation of that. Powers is awesome. So if you haven't read Powers, check it out. I've done a spotlight of Brian Michael Bendis. I'm probably going to do one for Michael Avon Oeming at some point, but check that out, because I talk about all the other things that I'm aware of, at least that I've experienced, that Brian Michael Bendis has done. I really like him as an author. I had to go back and look at when I got this book, almost 3 years ago, and what book came in its place initially, The Secret Lives of Midwives. So I have a video, one of my really early videos, where I mentioned that too. Let's check that out. But I enjoyed it. I gave it 4 stars. Really, it made me want to go back and read Powers again. The whole series. And maybe I'll do that. Maybe that'll be kind of a reread. Read all of them. Because I think it would be good to have them just read them straight through. And then, not necessarily read this one again, but kind of be reacquainted with Powers. I wish that this was a continuing series too. So Brian Michael Bendis, if you're watching this, please write more Powers. There are a couple that I think came after this. I think this is from 2016. So there are more current issues of Powers that happen later in the Powers history. But I would definitely recommend reading, if you want to read the secret history of Deena Pilgrim, read the Powers books that come before it. Check out what I think is a very cool thumbnail. I had a different version. I used some AI thing to turn my face into a cartoon face. But I think it worked out well. So check that out, because I did like it. I liked it. And that the other person in that picture is Deena. She looks a little different sometimes than other books, but she's very cool. Deena's cool. Christian's cool. There's a lot of cool characters in the Powers series, and I totally recommend it. And once you've gotten into it, I do recommend getting the backstory on Deena Pilgrim. Thanks for being here today. I will talk to you later. Have a good one. Bye.
Every now and then I get down to the end of a day, I have to stop. Ask myself why I've done it. It just seems so useless to have to work so hard and nothing ever really seemed to come from it. And then she looks me in the eye and says, we